Hi, Dad. I'm home from school.
Dad?
Huh? What? Oh. Hello, son.
Are you okay, Dad?
Yeah, sure. I guess I must have just, zoned out there for a minute. So, how was your day?
Well, it was all right. But on my way home from school, a couple of burnouts tried to get me hooked on drugs.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But I looked them right in the eye and just said no.
Good, good. You stood up for yourself. I'm proud of you, son.
Thanks, Dad. So, what's for dinner?
Oh, yeah. Dinner.
You're having dinner. You're having dinner with Dad. Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad. You're having dinner. You're having dinner with Dad. Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad. You're having dinner. You're having dinner with Dad. Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad. You're having dinner. You're having dinner with Dad. Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
No, we don't talk shop at the dinner table.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
Bass and green beans and twice baked potato.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
He presides over dinner, butter knife in hand.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
When he suddenly struck with a flashback to Vietnam.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
Eyes. Visions of napalm blast in the skies. But what has haunted him most as the years have passed by is a matter that remains highly classified. Hidden way down deep, he keeps the memory of an incident worse than any battle with the enemy. A chilling tale, a horror story that took place in a top secret laboratory. Uncle Sam had given the okay to an experiment with a mysterious code name, the aim of which was to test the effects of a new drug on human test subjects. Your pops had witnessed the whole ordeal, couldn't believe his eyes, it was so unreal. In a room full of scientific thingamajigs, were American servicemen being used as guinea pigs. Tubes were attached to the soldier's eardrums, squirting out a glowing golden serum, a powerful drug that went and raised hell, scrambling up the young men's brain cells. Dad snaps out of the flashback. He's back at the dinner table feeling like a sad sack. Depressed and broken, barely able to eat another bite of his twice-baked potato. Meanwhile, 3 miles down the road, a neighborhood street gang is about to unload a shipment of a drug of the exact same kind. Dad had seen drive men out of their minds. Yes, the very same drug used in the experiment is now being sold on the streets of America. Teens are taking it and it's making them spaz. And all the kids are calling it jazz.
Dad's got a stare like a mythical gorgon.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
You realize eyeballs are mystical organs.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
They don't just detect the light and movement.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
But also reflect back the life of a human.
Dinner, dinner, dinner with Dad.
Gigantic tent has covered the entire structure for the past few days.
This was the scene downtown today as disappointed tourists were turned away from the landmark. Authorities say that the fumigation was a success and that the observation deck will resume normal operating hours tomorrow.
I wonder what's bothering Dad. He seems so preoccupied lately. Maybe I should snoop around a bit. There could be a clue somewhere in his room that might help me figure out what's going on with him.
Oh, hi, Scruffles. Looks like somebody's ready for a walk.